we're going to go over how to maximize your tax deductions on a rental real estate property investment. Let's do this. How's it going? My name is John and I am a mortgage broker located in Vancouver. If you want to learn ways to be approved for a mortgage, home buying tips and other mortgage related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking on the notification bell so you won't miss anything. I'm here today with Hayson Chan, accountant at Truspect Consulting. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, John, for having me.
So Hayson, I have a few clients who have a real estate investment and they're wondering, how would you be able to help them pay as little tax as possible?
I think the best tip would be make sure that you include each and every single expenses that you generates rental income. Mm-hmm. We can go over a few of them. Okay. Advertising is the first one. If you have to, you know, post an ad online to get, you know, a tenant, that is tax deductible. So advertising is the first one. Second one would be the home insurance, right? Most of the time, you know, homeowners would like to protect and safeguard one of the most important asset, which is your home or your, you know, your investing property. So home insurance is also tax deductible. And a lot of clients actually talk to us and they're so confusing when it comes to paying mortgage, right? So only the mortgage interest, you know, tax deductible. The mortgage principal is not tax deductible.
Okay.
So make sure that you collect a statement from your bank or your creditor, and you only include the tax interest expense, mm-hmm. In your personal income tax return.
Okay.
And there are also a few, such as utilities, mm-hmm. You know, bills paid to, you know, BC Hydro, your telephone bill, your Wi-Fi bill, you know, everything is tax deductible.
Now, what if someone is just renting out their basement?
Mm-hmm.
How would that work and how would they be able to save tax on that?
That's a really good question, actually. If you rent out your basement only to help with the mortgage or, you know, make some money, only the portion that you rent out. So let's say you rent out 30% of the basement, mm-hmm. then 30% of all the household expenses actually are tax deductible, including the items that we went through: advertising, home insurance, mortgage interest, utilities, including Wi-Fi, you know, electricity, heat, you know, telephone, mm-hmm. and also property tax is a big one as well.
So, would that apply for Airbnb rentals?
Mm-hmm. Airbnb is also the same. Make sure that you keep track of all the income that you receive and all the expenses that you pay, and categorize, you know, according to the list that we provide, mm-hmm. and you can claim everything as expenses. But one tip to keep in mind is to make sure that you check with the strata corporation, because some strata corporation, you know, they don't allow you to rent it out as a short-term rental, Airbnb, mm-hmm. and also it depends on the jurisdiction under the city.
Mm-hmm. So what are some things that people may forget to expense?
Actually, when it comes to collecting rental income, it's much like, you know, running a business. So every single penny that you pay or expenses to generate income is actually tax deductible. So one thing that a lot of landlords forget is actually, you know, even vehicle expenses, you know, vehicles such as, you know, gas that you pay, car insurance, repair, maintenance, and parking. When you drive from your home to go talk to your tenant, actually that mileage is actually tax deductible. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to claiming vehicle expenses, make sure that you keep a mileage logbook. Mm-hmm. And I would say, you know, a lot of people, they don't bother to do that. But when the CRA review or audit, they do have the right to make sure that you show the proof. Mm-hmm.
So Hayson, when I'm reviewing someone's T1 mm-hmm. general and looking through the rental statement of the T1,
mm-hmm.
I see a capital cost allowance.
Yeah, the CCA.
Yeah, CCA.
Yeah.
So what is that, and should someone be using that to expense?
Right. There are different types of, there are different classes of CCA, you know, which the CRA has, you know, clear guidelines to talk about what is the percentage that you can claim. Mm-hmm. So if you own a real estate, if you own a investing property, yeah. and if you claim the CCA over its useful age, then technically you receive more benefits because the net income is actually so low that you don't have to pay taxes at all.
Mm-hmm.
But keep in mind that when you sell the property, you might have to pay more capital gain tax. That's called a recapture of taxes.
Okay.
Think about it like, you know, you've been, you know, enjoying having advantage over the useful years when you own the property. Mm-hmm. When you sell it, the CRA say no. Like you've been taking a lot of advantage already before, which is a lot of benefits. Now the property is sold, you have to pay more taxes than you can even imagine. So yes or no claim that, again, it's a tax planning question. It really depends on, you know, the cap rate that you're receiving as a landlord. And also, you know, is there going to be a big tax bill down the road?
So if someone is watching this video and they have more questions about tax savings for rental properties,
right? They can contact you. They can contact me. Contact our firm for phone number and email, and it's in the description area.
Perfect. And there you go. We just went over how to minimize paying taxes for someone who has a rental real estate investment. And please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel to learn more. And make sure you click on the notification bell so you won't miss a video. I'm John Lee, mortgage broker and CEO of Rise Mortgage. We are always achieving your approval.